Hey guys, my name is Pedrotsky, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can install eggs on Pterodactyl. Now, eggs are basically server configuration files that will allow you to run other game servers that don't come with the default installation of Pterodactyl. So if we have a look at Pterodactyl as a default, let's just go to servers, create new, and then we can see the only real games we have here are like Source Engine games. There's just a handful of Source Engine, Rust, and some Minecraft servers and like TeamSpeak. So there is actually like a pretty big community when it comes to Pterodactyl, and a lot of these community members have made eggs. And there's a GitHub repository here. I'll give you a link to this in the description. It's by Parker, and basically this is just a whole bunch of different configurations for like different game servers. So for example, if we go into game eggs here, we can go down to Steam CMD servers, and then like look at all the Steam games that we can install just by importing a configuration. So let's get started now. Let's go to Pterodactyl, and then let's look at, so basically we have nests down here. So if we click on nests, we can see it says Minecraft, Source Engine, Voice Servers, and Rust. Now, a nest basically just holds a bunch of different eggs. So for this demonstration, we're going to go create new, and we're going to call it custom eggs. Actually, let's call it custom game servers. And then click save. And then it says here, nest eggs, new egg. Don't click on this. This will basically, if you want to configure an egg, all we're doing is importing an existing egg. So if you just click nests again, it will bring you back to this screen here. And then we need to download this repository. So when you click the link on the description, it's going to bring you to this GitHub page here. And it's pretty straightforward. Don't be intimidated by it, but all we need to do is click on code and then click on download zip. And basically what that's going to do, that's going to download everything in here. So all of these scripts, don't worry, it's only like, it's not much, it's just scripts. It's basically a text file. So we've got that downloaded, and then all we need to do is just extract it. So I've extracted mine already. So if I go into eggs master, you can see here, I've got all the game eggs in here, Steam CMD. And what we'll do for this demonstration, let's install Sven Co-op. So the Sven Co-op here, and then as you'll see, there is a JSON file here. So all we need to do is go back to Pterodactyl, click on import egg, click choose file, and then we just navigate to the game egg that we want to install. So in this case, we're going to install Sven Co-op. So what was it? Steam CMD servers. Sven Co-op, double click the egg, and then we're going to change the associated nest to custom game servers. So click import. There we go. So now that's imported, we can just go and start the server how we would any other server. So basically I'm just going to click on servers, create new, let's go Sven test, let's gear. If you've never set up a server before, I've got a link in the description, and basically I'll just show you how you can set up a game server inside of Pterodactyl. If you want me to do a tutorial on specific games, just leave a comment below and I'll do a tutorial on that. So now this is where we select our nest. So now we're going to click custom game servers, and then we see it's got Sven Co-op there. And then all we need to do is literally click create server. And there we go, our game server is installing. So this will basically exactly the same as any other Pterodactyl egg. It's just going to install and we'll be able to run the game server. It's really that simple to get other games up and running. So this Parker resource is a great, it's like a great GitHub just for different scripts, and there's all sorts of things you can run, like even bots here. They got like some Discord bots. Like they've got Sinus bot, so you can run like music in your Discord, and Parkatron, like a whole bunch of things. So check it out, and yeah, that's it guys. It's a super quick and simple video. I hope that helps you get your eggs and game servers set up in Pterodactyl. So thanks for watching, guys, and I hope to see you in the next video.